Hi, so welcome. Today I am going to discuss fertility over 40 and supporting our reproductive health over 40. And I'm going to give you all a few moments to settle in. We had some technical difficulties with internet here on Tuesday, but hopefully it looks like today it's a little bit better. I think all the internet was affected because of all the smoke. We're here in Colorado and we're having some fires that luckily seem like they're being contained, but I think the smoke was just too much and some signals were getting crossed on Tuesday. So if you were here Tuesday, sorry, hold on a bit. Okay, so welcome. I actually posted that I was going to do this live video, and it's interesting because I'll sell my teas and sell my products, and I don't always know what happens to them after we ship them out. Usually we'll put a nice blessing over them and send them on their way, and I don't always know who receives them. And often I do get messages back from women, but sometimes I don't. So today I posted that I was going to do this live video about getting pregnant after age 40. And we got a message, a response that said, "I'm 43 and after two miscarriages, decided to try your Fertile Mama tea. I used it for two cycles and am now 26 weeks pregnant with a healthy baby boy. Thank you, Ariel, for helping me along in this journey to have a sibling for my 2-year-old baby girl and not letting age or fertility doctors make me believe it was over. I wasn't going to do IVF or IUI. Even if they said I was a candidate, which I wasn't, God makes the impossible possible. Believe, ladies, and buy the tea." So that was like amazing because sometimes I even am like, someone will reach out to me and tell me they're 45, and I feel hesitant to, promise them anything. I mean, of course, I never promise anything. But the reason I wanted to talk about fertility as we get older. And I said 40, but really, even if you're 35, this would impact you. Often people come to me and say, "Does your fertility really drop significantly at age 35 or age 37 or at age 40?" And the answer is yes and no. So the answer is no in that, it's not like all of a sudden you hit that age and your fertility just stops, like your reproductive health just stops. I always try to get the point across that our reproductive health is really just a reflection and a manifestation of our overall health. So if we're having fertility issues or infertility, it's just a symptom of overall health. And often, we all have imbalances. We all get imbalances. Even when we're little kids, we have imbalances. And it's kind of no fault of our own. It might be due to our genetic patterning and our genetic makeup, or our lifestyle choices, or trauma. So I don't ever want anyone to feel like bad or shamed or guilty about, having imbalances. Even those of us who are totally healthy and do our best to be as healthy as possible, we'll still get imbalances in our body. And luckily, when I feel an imbalance in my body, I know what to do. I know what to look for, and I know what to do to treat it in myself. But if you're not like a healthcare practitioner yourself, you might not know, what to do. If you feel like a headache or a digestive pain or a little constipation or diarrhea, it might just be like, "Well, that's just me. That's just normal," And while it might be common, it's not necessarily like healthy or a sign that your body is in balance. So the reason that often fertility will drop at 35 or 37 or 40 is the same reason that, I mean, I'm 41, and probably 2 years ago, I started to hear from like the guy that I went to high school with had a heart attack, or the girl that I went to high school with was diagnosed with breast cancer, or the people that I knew who were kind of doing some drugs in high school. Finally died from doing drugs, whereas their body could kind of handle it before. Was at like age 37, they died from doing the same thing they had been doing, or they were diagnosed with cancer, or often I'll get people come in that are around that age whose symptoms are getting worse, like their headaches are getting worse, like they maybe always had headaches, but now they're worse, or their insomnia is worse, or, diabetes comes up. So the reality is that I always talk about our bodies as kind of like these spiraling balls of energy, you know? And if we have an imbalance in there, over time, that imbalance will kind of throw things off and you'll get little knots in your energy, your flow of energy. You'll get like knots. And over time, those knots will accumulate and accumulate and accumulate until finally you get the thing that's then like a symptom, or God forbid, a heart attack, or something that is, it's always been an imbalance, but as we kind of age, they accumulate and accumulate and accumulate. The good news is that there are lots and lots of things we can do to reverse that accumulation. And that's why often, I'll have someone who's 40 who comes in and maybe they'll do like a month worth of acupuncture and then say, I don't notice a difference. I'm gonna give up. The thing is that if you have 10 more years of this accumulation of imbalance than someone who's 30, it does take a little more time to unravel it. And so like I said, I'm 41, but I'm constantly doing things to bring myself into balance. And this is, I'm regularly taking supplements and herbs. While I tend to be pretty anti the diet culture, like I'm pretty anti diet culture, but I will say that what we put into our body greatly impacts and affects our overall health. And I do see our overall health as just the same as our overall longevity. So there are people at 40 who have been having really kind of unhealthy lifestyles from the time they're 20, and it will be harder for them to get pregnant than someone who has like been really, really conscious and may just have like a little imbalance that just needs to be unraveled. So that said, what you're putting into your body is really important, as well as your lifestyle choices. So, you ever feel like if those of you who are watching are over 35, you might find that the things you could kind of get away with when you were 30, like pulling an all-nighter or drinking more, you might now feel the effects of that kind of thing more that you're a little older. And it's just that imbalance, whatever that imbalance that acute has accumulated, it's like your body feels that more. So, like I said, it's not a sharp decline. It's not like you'll be fertile, 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 and then all of a sudden you hit 40 and you're still, and then you're like just not fertile anymore. Typically, it's been like a slow buildup of whatever that imbalance is. So, there are lots of things you could do. And, someone once asked me, like, would you treat somebody who's 40 who comes into your treatment room differently than you'll treat somebody who's 30? But the reality is that I'm always just looking at the body in front of me, So the imbalances that are in anybody would be the same as you get older. So you could still have dampness, you could still have blood deficiency, you could still have qi deficiency, you could still have stagnation. The tendencies that I seem to see kind of becoming exacerbated as somebody gets older are like if we've had stagnation, this like stress and buildup of stress over time. That means for however many years you've been releasing cortisol, the hormone cortisol, which is the stress hormone, into your bloodstream. And that over time will throw off your hormone balance. And then your stagnation that it causes will become like more and more exacerbated. The liver is what controls the flow of energy through the body. And the liver is also what we process pharmaceuticals through, and foods and toxins through. So if you've been on a lot of pharmaceutical drugs or recreational drugs, different prescription medications, or you've been drinking, or you have a tendency to do recreational drugs, that might be the kind of thing that by the time you hit 35, your liver is really sluggish. And so you're just not processing your hormones. And so your hormone balance will be off. So really detoxifying your liver. I don't recommend that anybody just go off their prescription medications, but perhaps look at why you're on them and talk to your doctor about them and see if like dietary changes maybe could help you wean off of them or reduce your dosage, but don't do that yourself, please. let me just see. None of you guys are commenting. You say hi. I think that my internet is still actually slow here, so apologies if my video or sound is funny, but let's see. Okay. So I was talking about like the patterns that tend to build up. Often, I mentioned stagnation. Sometimes we have more blood deficiency as we get older, especially if we have regular cycles and we're bleeding. Women bleed. If we're not replenishing those blood that we're losing with blood tonics and red meat, we could become blood deficient, and you'd know that if you get like dizzy or lightheaded or floaters in your eyes. We often might tend as we get older to have some heat in our body, and whether that heat is from the stagnation I talked about before, or like we don't have enough estrogen, our estrogen is declining, maybe because of the heat, so we're getting yin deficiency, which is then affecting our follicles, so our follicles can start to decline a little bit. So improving your yin so that you can support your follicles becomes really healthy. So things that support your yin, things that nourish your blood, things that move your qi. And I try not to use these videos to like sell my products, but I do create the teas specifically for balancing out your body. So whatever your imbalance is, and it's not like there's one imbalance that every woman over 40 would have. I could have 10 different women who are age 40 come into my clinic, and they'd have 10 different, patterns of imbalance. So, that said, I will say that I have treated a lot of women who are 40 and even above who have gotten pregnant. And actually, I have a friend who she actually used to be an acupuncturist at my clinic in New Jersey. And she was getting a little panicky because she was single. She was approaching her 40th birthday, and she went out on her 40th birthday and had a really good time and got pregnant, like one and done. And the thing is that we had been, as acupuncturists working together, we would always give each other trades. We would always be like taking different herbal formulas. So it's important to really pay attention to your body and just notice the things that we might otherwise just write off as like, oh, this is just my normal thing. Because the things that like bother us about our health, like our headaches or our constipation or our stomach aches or our like joint pain or whatever it is, those are the things that we could look at to look at like what is the imbalance contributing to that, because that might also be the contributing factor for infertility. I had a patient who had been trying to get pregnant for quite a few years, and she also had terrible headaches, and finally her doctor put her on this medication for her headaches that she was not allowed to get pregnant on because the medication was so toxic that if she had a baby while she was taking this medication, the baby would probably have some birth defects. So she came to me to help her with her headaches and so that she could get off her medication. She had like a ton of stagnation, her liver was really clogged, she had a ton of heat, if you think about heat rising, so she was getting really bad headaches, also like night sweats and hot flashes, the things that you kind of note in menopause sometimes, or as you get older or pre-menopause, this is usually heat. That would be like deficiency heat, like you don't have enough cooling. She actually had excess heat. So we brought her body into balance. She was able to get off the medication. The idea was that after she got off the medication, she wanted to go in for IVF. But actually, we kind of reversed the patterning enough that she actually got pregnant on her own. So that's the good news. I definitely wouldn't lose hope if you're 40 and you've been trying for a while. But I will say that it's not just like you can do nothing and you'll get pregnant. Usually we have to really focus on reversing those imbalances in our body. And the first place to look always are at the places in our lives where we know where we're kind of off balance. So do you tend to get stressed really easily? Is your job stressful? Is your lifestyle stressful? Are you getting adequate sleep every night? What's your diet like? Are you really nourishing your body with like nutritional foods? I just think especially like alcohol can be really hard on your liver, recreational drug use, smoking, and there's lots of things you could do to support your body. And I would definitely go back and read through my blogs about the yin phase and supporting your yin, because as we get older, the yin will definitely decline. So anyway, that's all the time I have. I wish I could stay longer. Your guys' comments are not coming through to me today, so I wish that I could answer questions. I think because the internet is kind of slow here, I'm not able to answer your questions. So hopefully you can just, if you want to leave a question, if you're watching this either live or after the fact, you can post hashtag live or hashtag repost so I know when you've been watching it. And then you could ask me your question and I'll try to answer it in the next video. I think I need to get my technical things under wraps. But anyway, if you're 35, 37, 40, no, your fertility does not just like psh, decline out of nowhere, but there are things that you probably need to do to reverse the imbalances that have been accumulating for, 20 years even, 30 years even. Okay, so thank you so much for coming in. It's always good to talk to you. And I'll definitely be back doing some more lives next week. Hopefully my technical difficulties will be fixed. And I'll see you then. Bye.